The engines like to be responsible, reliable, and really useful. They're happy once your top hat gives them important work. And most of the engines like to be really useful. It was a splendid day, and the engines knew they liked to be reliable and really useful. And most of the engines like to be on time or late. One day, Diesel was upset after he hung over on the Kirkland viaduct when Scruffy used his powers to mess with him. He was shunting trucks in the yards for the trouble he caused. Bruno had noticed Diesel was upset.
I don't know what's with that guy. Oh, it wasn't your fault, Diesel. It was Scruffy that caused it.
But Diesel was still upset about it. And not only that, he has to shunt trucks with Hackworth in the yards. Later, Diesel came into Hackworth Station, and Richard was there. Richard was getting ready to take the boat train from Nefford Station to Brendam Docks, and then he has to take it to the Smudger Station Harbor and then Fenton Harbor. Hello there, Diesel.
Oh, hey, Richard. I heard you've been saved from scrap. Well, most engines don't have to be saved from scrap. Some has to wait to be surprised during it.
Hey, Henry had saved me from scrap once. You should give respect to others for once.
Oh, really? But everyone knows that I'm the one that noticed it. We Diesels don't have to worry about it. We know everything. And we are revolutionary.
Oh, revolutionary? I heard about that. Duck told me about you. You're the one that tell lies in front of Gordon, James, and Henry.
Me and Hackworth know everything, and we don't have any problems.
Oh, really? Well, at least I don't understand you. I think you had a foul mouth or something.
Richard was about to say something when the conductor blew his whistle. Richard just went off, still worried and still speechless.
See you later, Richard.
Whenever Richard sees Diesel and Hackworth, they say massive things to him.
Don't get dirty, dusted Richard.
Richard tried to ignore them, but all of it, the stuff Diesel and Hackworth say, got into his smoke box. It made Richard upset.
I don't know what's with Diesel and Hackworth, Nia, but they're saying messed up things, and all the stuff they said, they keep coming back into my smoke box.
Don't let them get to you, Richard. They're just trying to be difficult on you. And the way they went is messed up, and don't let them get on your nerves.
I know, but all the stuff they're saying makes me irritated. And I don't think I could deal with their stuff they're saying. And it hurts my feelings when they said those things.
Well, don't let them get to you, Richard. Just think of something.
Richard said nothing. He was
bit unsure, but he noticed Neo was right. And with that, Richard went off. He was still thinking about what Diesel and Hackworth said.
Poor Richard. I hope there's some way to make Diesel and Hackworth stop.
Don't worry, Nia. I'm sure Richard will be fine. Later, Richard talked to Edward that night at Tim's sheds.
I don't know what's with Diesel and Hackworth. They think the part where I got into an accident that I got covered in coal dust was funny. Now I don't know what's with them.
Don't mind what Diesel and Hackworth say, Richard. Everyone knows you do things so well. You might cause a few mistakes, but everyone knows you're really useful.
I don't know, but all the stuff they said keeps making things difficult.
Of course. Everyone thinks you're awesome. Everyone knows that when Henry saves you from scrap, then everyone thinks you're special.
Richard realized everyone was right, and without saying anything else, he went to sleep. Later, the next day, Richard was at Brendan Docks getting ready to take a freight train. He was still upset. Cranky and Bruno noticed it.
Are you okay, Richard?
I'm fine. I just can't believe Diesel had the nerve to say those things, and Hackworth just insulted me.
When Richard explained everything, Cranky and Bruno were surprised.
He didn't.
Well, he did, Cranky. I just can't believe he insulted me that way.
Richard, maybe you should give Hackworth a break.
Oh, I will. Later. Just need to come up with something for a payback. I'll show them. And with that, Richard went off, still thinking of a way to pay Diesel and Hackworth back.
This is gonna be a big mess, I'm sure of it. Oh well, I'll send a message to 10 cents about it later.
Hackworth was still working alone. He was still thinking about what to say to Richard when they next met along with Diesel. That bottom hole. I was trying to make things better until that Richard ruined it. Richard will get it, but Hackworth didn't know what to do.
Later, Hackworth's driver had heard him, and he explained everything to his firemen.
Hackworth didn't notice it, and he doesn't know what they're saying, but Hackworth's driver knew it's gonna be crazy.
Later that evening, Richard was at Nefford Station waiting for the coaches to arrive. He was still thinking about what Hackworth and Diesel said when they heard something.
Oh no, not them again.
Later, Hackworth and Diesel were coming with coal trucks, taking coal trucks from the coal depot. Then Diesel realized something.
It seems our brake fin is loose, Hackworth. We can't go anywhere with a loose brake fin.
Oh no! Look out, Diesel, Hackworth! Diesel and Hackworth realized they noticed something was wrong, and then they didn't notice the points weren't set, and they realized they're heading on the same track as Richard.
Oh no! Look out, Diesel and Hackworth!
Diesel and Hackworth tried to stop, but it was too late.
Diesel, Hackworth, look what you've done!
No one was hurt, but Hackworth was embarrassed and Diesel was foolish.
The next morning, soon as Diesel and Hackworth were put back on the rails and repaired, they felt guilt. They felt messed up for the way they went, and
they apologized to Richard. We shouldn't have been messing with you, Richard. Yeah, we're very sorry. It's alright, Diesel and Hackworth. I know you didn't mean to. And at least you did try your best to stop when you noticed that I was on the same track as you guys. Diesel and Hackworth said nothing. They felt foolish. Well, at least you don't have to worry about those problems. Indeed, Cuphead. At least I don't have to worry about it. After what happened, Richard felt much better now. He had already forgotten the stuff that Diesel and Hackworth said, and he felt much better. Diesel and Richard are now friends, and things have went better. As for Diesel, when Sir Topham had heard what he and Hackworth did, Sir Topham had decided to have Diesel stay at the Diesel Works in his shed for 5 days. Diesel said nothing. He had a lot to think about for what he and Hackworth did. But it looks like he won't be messing with Richard anymore, don't you?
Mm-hmm.